Joined today on Mobile World Live by Bertis Downs. Bertis has been the advisor for REM for the last 30 years. Welcome.
Thanks very much.
We're standing in Hanserton Studios, which is where REM recorded their last and what would be final album. Over those 30 years, the music industry has gone through significant changes. What's kind of stood out for you?
Well, I mean, when we started, we had to make this big decision a couple of years into our career having an office on whether to get a fax machine or not. I mean, this new exotic technology that allowed you to write something and then people could see it almost instantaneously was kind of remarkable. We just couldn't believe it. Things have changed a lot since then. I'm not even sure we still have a fax machine. I'm pretty sure we donated the last one because we don't even need it anymore. But I mean, really, it's a fairly obvious thing that's happened in the amount of time since REM got started. To a certain extent, things are the same. Still, a band gets started, they try to get, you know, their music out there. They try to have people get excited about their music, give them something to, you know, talk about and to pass on to their friends and to, you know, spread the word. That's still the same. There's just so many different ways of doing it now, and we've moved from a world of scarcity and gatekeepers where a limited amount of stuff gets released every year, and you're competing within that fairly finite world to an unlimited amount of stuff. The history of the recorded music world is all there, and it's a very different math. It's a very different, you know, musicians today are signing up for a much different job than they signed up for in 1980 when our guys got started.
Does a band like REM pay a lot of close attention to progress in technology, or is that where the likes of the advisors such as yourself come in?
I think it's both. I mean, I think, in my situation, it's three guys in the band. They're all very different, but at the same time, you know, everybody does email, everybody's on the internet, everybody's sharing apps and talking to their friends, and it's just, you know, it's the world in which everybody lives. So I can think of plenty of examples where it's more on myself, people at the label, to kind of navigate or to present certain choices. But at the end of the day, it's, you know, with everything REM ever did as a democracy, as a collaborative where they all, you know, had equal say, we kind of come to a consensus on that, and it's their decision.
How much of an impact has the boom in mobile usage and smartphones had on the consumption of mobile music, and what kind of impact is that having on artists, do you think, as well?
I think it's too early to tell, to be honest. I mean, I'm just hearing things and stuff like this. I know about the rise of YouTube. I'm aware of Spotify. I'm a premium subscriber to Spotify. I don't use it that much, but I pay my $9.95 a month. So, I'm aware of it, but in terms of it having any tangible effect on things like royalty statements, not aware of it that much. It feels early in the, it must be very early in the overall arc of the streaming on mobile. Obviously, you know, it depends on the genre, it depends on the artist, depends on where they are in their career. We've gone from being a band that was, you know, putting out albums for 30 years to a band that now has those albums, the body of work. Now we're, I guess, a catalog band, a legacy band, and it's a different business for us now, and we're still sort of figuring it out.
Finally, I have to ask, the band obviously announced their split last year. Is there any chance of a reunion?
Oh, I really try not to predict the future. It's just, you know, I'm sort of not going to be surprised if they do. I'm not going to be surprised if they don't. I think the answer is no. I mean, when we were last in this, where I'm sitting right now, was the sort of backstage area for the last time REM ever played. They actually played a little set of the songs that were finished from the most recent album, which they recorded here at Hanzo Studio in the room next door. And this was kind of a little backstage area where the friends and family were gathering, went in there, and about an hour was spent watching REM play the last time they were ever going to play as a combo. I think it's a final decision. I think they just decided they didn't want to do this anymore. They wanted to pursue other things, and they've had their run, and they want to leave it gracefully at the right time. Would they ever switch that? They're human beings. They're alive. They're well. They're talented musicians. So I'm not going to be surprised either way, but I'm not expecting it.
Okay. Well, there's a lot of fans that would like to see it.
Yeah, I'm one of them. Okay. Sure.
Bertis, thanks very much. Cheers.
Thanks. Thank you.